Knowing the right ways to save and investing in simple changes to your home makes your home more comfortable, safe, and enjoyable to live in. Here to share with us some saving tips for our home and how to grow into our homes and not out of them is Aldea Douglas of AARP. Aldea, nice to see you again.
Absolutely. Great to be here.
Are you once again jet-setting, bouncing all over the place?
Yes.
Okay, so we're talking about here modifications to our house. What are some ways that we can modify our house in order for it to make it more livable, friendly, and better for everybody?
So there are many things, economical things that you can do to your home to make it more livable. Something as easy as adding night lights to your bathroom.
Okay.
And some people will say, why night lights to your bathroom? Well, how many people get up in the middle of the night to try and use the bathroom and have to find and fiddle with the
and
light?
And you don't want to leave the light on all night, obviously.
Absolutely. So you have a night light to help you get through there. Night lights are great for the kitchen area as well.
Yes, very true. You don't have to feel your way into that switch.
Absolutely.
As what most of us do, right?
Yeah.
And so a lot of people though may be worried about, because if you do this modification, if you add this fixture and that those things can add up.
Absolutely.
Right. So what are ways, what would your advice be in order to save on utility bills, in order to really maximize and lessen the costs that we have in our homes? What advice can you give our nation?
So consider adding a programmable thermostat to your home. Thermostats run under $100.
Oh, only $100?
Only $100, yes, absolutely. I mean, they run higher if you like, but you can get a very nice programmable thermostat for under $100.
Okay.
And install it yourself or hire someone to do it. And that way, that could cut your costs almost in half in terms of the your heating and air bills.
Now, you mentioned somewhere in there to at some point ask for professional help in order to install or add something. What would your advice is? What are the steps in order to finding the right person, whether it be a contractor or an electrician, in order to help you with these needs?
So first you need to determine if you need to hire a contractor. And many times people will think that they don't need a contractor. So go out and ask a relative or a friend, what do they think about your work that you're doing?
Yeah.
9 times out of 10, you might need to hire a contractor. Everyone can't install a
These days
fan.
People say DIY. No, we cannot do everything.
Can't do everything.
You know that. It's dangerous. And like I said, cut costs on some of these things so you can afford hiring somebody who can do it better for you.
Absolutely. Ask for a recommendation from a family or friend, first of all. Try and get estimates from at least 3 people. That's important in terms of cost, as well as vetting enough people that you know that you're making the right decision.
Mm-hmm.
And lastly, do not make the final payment until the work is done, on any work that's done in your home. That's a great way to make sure that the work is either done or you don't feel cheated in terms of the work if there's any issues in terms
done
of the quality.
Done, or it well suits exactly what you need and what you're looking for.
Absolutely.
Sometimes it's there, but this will work better if it was this way. Very good. All these wonderful stuff, Aldea. Thank you so much for joining us once again to help our nation have a better understanding of how we can improve our lifestyle and living in our homes. If we have any more questions, what website can they go to in order to pick up on more details and ways here?
So visit aarp.org/homefit. We have great tools and resources that you can download to help
tools
you.
And technique.
Tools and technique, absolutely.
Thank you so much, Aldea.
Thank you.
See you again soon.